everyone. Now today we are here to do an experiment. Aim of this experiment is tracing the path of a ray of light passing through a glass prism. Let's discuss some theory related to this topic. Here we will discuss the phenomena refraction of the light. Refraction of the light means that when the light travels from one medium to the another medium, it shifts its path. It is shifted towards the normal when it is going from the rarer to denser medium, and it is shifted away from the normal when it is going from the denser to rarer medium. Here the medium that we will use to do the refraction of the light is a glass prism. Glass prism can be formed by taking three square sheets or three rectangular sheets, and we have to arrange that sheets in such a way that they are forming two triangles on the opposite sides. Material required to do this activity are drawing board, white sheet, drawing pins to adjust the white screen on the drawing board that I have already done, one glass prism. The glass prism that I am using here have the three square sides of the dimensions 38 × 38 mm, one protector, normal pins, sketch pens, scale, pencil. Here I am doing this activity with the help of the sketch pen, but you will do this activity with the pencil. Now let's start the activity. First of all, we will place this prism on the white sheet such that the triangular side will touch the sheet. Now I will draw the boundary of the prism with the help of sketch. When I will draw the boundary of the glass prism, I will get a triangular boundary. Now name the boundary as A, B, C. Now I have marked one point Q on the side AB. On this point, I will draw a normal with the help of a protector. Now I will join these two points to get a normal on the side AB. Now let this normal is N1, N2. Now at the point Q, I will draw an angle of 60 degree . This is the point for the angle 60 degree which is making with N1 N2 normal. Now I will join this point with Q to get a straight line. This line, let it is RQ, it will act as a incident ray on the side AB, which is making an angle of incidence, and it is equals to 60 degree. Our angle of incidence is 60 degree, and this ray is incident ray. This RQ ray is the incident ray. Now on this RQ ray, I will mark 2 points at a distance of approximately 4 centimeters. This is my point P1. This is the point P2. Now on these 2 points, I will adjust 2 pins in the vertical manner. These 2 pins should be straight. Now I will adjust the glass prism in between the boundaries ABC. Now I will see the image of the pins P1 and P2 from the side AC. As you can see that I have adjusted 2 pins in such a way that the 4 pins should be in the straight line. These two pins I have adjusted by looking from the side AC. Now I will remove these 2 pins and I will mark the point for these 2 pins. Now I will remove this prism also. Now I will join these 2 points. I'm removing these 2 pins also. Now I will join these 2 points to make a straight line. Let this line meet the side AC at the point E. And these 2 points, I'm naming it as P3 and P4. Now I am joining the point Q and E to get a straight line. Now at the point E, I am drawing 1 normal. That normal is on the side AC. Using the protractor, I am marking a point for the angle 90 degree. Now I will join this point with the point E to get a normal on the side AC. Let this normal is N3, N4. Now what is happening here? RQ is the incident ray, which making an angle of incidence 60 degree with N1, N2 normal. It is refracted along the path QE. You can see that it is shifted towards the normal. If I will show you with the help of the scale, then if I will produce the incident ray forward, then it is the straight line. If this prism is not there, then the incident ray will travel in the straight line. But now it is shifted towards the normal along the path QE. Now it means that this QE ray is refracted ray. This QE ray, when come to the side AC, here again it is changing the medium. It is going from denser to rarer medium. So that's why it is again changing its path. It should go in this way. If I will produce QE in the forward direction, then it should go in this way. But now it is shifted away from the normal. So this is my ET ray, is emergent ray. And the emergent ray making an angle with the normal, and this is the angle of emergence, which I am denoting by angle E. Now we want to find out the angle of deviation by which the incident ray deviated when it is going from rarer to denser medium, that is from air to glass prism. To find out the angle of deviation, I will produce the incident ray in the forward direction and the emergent ray in the backward direction. Now you can see that this is the point where incident ray, produced incident ray and produced emergent ray intersecting each other. Now let this point is K. So the angle KET, which is between the produced incident and produced emergent ray, is known as angle of deviation. So the angle KET is the angle of deviation, which is denoted by DS. If I will calculate the measurement of this angle of deviation with the help of the protractor, then I will get the value. You can see that it is 40 degrees. So our angle of deviation is 40 degrees. This angle of deviation I am getting for the angle of incidence 60 degrees. But if I will change the angle of incidence, I will get other value of the angle of deviation, because the angle of deviation depends upon the angle of incidence, medium with which the glass prism is formed. It is also depending upon the ray of light, color of the ray of light that is incident on the glass prism. So it changes its value in every condition. Now if I will show the path of the ray of light going from the glass prism, then it is RQ. Q E and then E T. It means the path of the ray of light is R Q E T. In this path, ray of light has changed its path two times, one at the point Q because it is going from the rarer to denser medium and it is shifted towards the normal, and second at the point E where it is going from denser to rarer medium, that's why it is shifted away from the normal. So the path of ray of light is R Q E T. The interpretation of this activity is that when the light changes its medium, it also changes its path, and the angle of deviation depends upon the angle of incidence and the conditions. I hope this activity is clear to you and you have enjoyed it. Thank you so much.